Nowadays, in any locality, there's this old lady sitting on a couch with a clutter of cats. Maybe it's your aunt or grandma or anyone else. Whoever she's known as the crazy cat lady in your neighborhood. There are rumors all around that she never gets out of her home. Are these just rumors, or can cats actually cause mental illnesses? Cats can be really adorable sometimes, but the question is, do they cause schizophrenia? Cats are associated with really superstitious beliefs, like if a cat sneezes 3 times a day, someone will catch a cold, or if a black cat crosses your path, you'll have a bad day. So is it true that cats cause schizophrenia, or is it a superstitious belief as well? So to unravel this mystery, cat owners, fasten your seatbelts and explore the world of cats. Before we get into all that, let's first understand what schizophrenia actually is. Schizophrenia is one of the most misunderstood and stigmatized illnesses today. So let's walk through what we know.
Delusions. People think that they will be harmed by a specific group of people without evidence, or believe that they are the richest person in the world. These were examples of persecutory and grandiose delusion. Other delusions are referential delusions, such as nihilistic or somatic delusions. Hallucinations. People tend to hear voices speaking to them, but hallucination can also be visual. For example, when someone sees something that doesn't exist. Disorganized speech or thinking may include switching between topics with no connection really fast. Sometimes it can be so incomprehensible that others don't understand what's going on. Abnormal movements. This is where a person experiences lack of movement and communication. Decreased emotional expression. This is when someone shows diminished emotional expression, where a person can be very monotonous. For instance, speaking like a robot.
This worsening is usually a product of genetic tendency combined with stress, but it can be accelerated with external diseases or parasites. Though only 1% of the population is affected with schizophrenia, children or siblings who are diagnosed with schizophrenia are 10 times likelier to develop this disease. So how can cats be related to such a complex disease? As I had mentioned earlier, a certain parasite appears to be an etiological factor of schizophrenia, and it turns out that one of those potentially accelerating parasites can be found in our feline friend. The parasite Toxoplasma gondii, T. gondii for short, can be found in garden, soil, and raw meat. So you see that this parasite can only reproduce inside cats. And if it gets into a human through the excretions of the affected cat, it may cause a full-blown infection called toxoplasmosis.
So what happens is that once the parasite gets into the cat through contaminated water, or probably through any other animal, the eggs mature and start reproducing inside the cat, and then gradually the cat will excrete more parasite eggs through its feces, and the cycle continues.
Once it gets into a human, it can't reproduce anymore, but there is still some really bad news. The T. gondii can harm any cell, especially immune cells. And you know what an immune cell is like? A Trojan horse. It lets the T. gondii board gene and conquer more specialized cells, like the brain cells, and cause cysts to form inside human neurons. Now the tricky part is that there are no symptoms. You may have a mild flu on a clear day, and turns out it's toxoplasmosis. Studies show that over 1/3 people could have it without knowing at all. Slowly, the parasite can grow stronger and cause the person to have more severe symptoms like muscle spasms, seizures, lack of concentration, poor coordination, etc. This parasite can affect a protein that transports glutamate. Glutamate is an excitatory neurotransmitter which helps neurons connect. This dysregulation of glutamate can cause ALS, Parkinson's disease, multiple sclerosis, and a lot more. In addition, many studies have also shown that the immune cells start to produce a lot of GABA. Now, GABA is a natural brain relaxant which makes us feel good, but too much GABA can make us fearless. For example, in the study, infected mice were not scared of cats and would be eaten up more often. Plus point for the T. gondii, it can continue the cycle. Now that I've scared you enough,
psychiatrist Ifula Toy says, if you're living in a crowded house in lower socioeconomic conditions, you may be more exposed to cats.
Now, owning a cat and being exposed to cats are not the same thing. That's just the thing. Scientists aren't still sure. Though many studies have been taking place, no conclusive results have been shown. The current agreement is that there is a definite correlation between cats and schizophrenia, but it is very unlikely that the animals are a causal factor for the development for this disorder. But cats don't actually cause someone to cause schizophrenia itself, but the parasite T. gondii found in some cats.
A study from Duke University took blood samples from over 800 people to look for T. gondii antibodies and did other surveys and tests to collect data about their behavior. About 28% of the participants tested positive for parasite antibodies.
But the researchers didn't find a significant association with schizophrenia, depression, or any other mental disorders, or any link to impulsive activities such as car accidents or crime. As it would be super unethical to just give people T. gondii and monitor the brain, the researchers did it on mice instead. But the research can therefore be very tricky, as mice aren't humans. But that's no reason to ditch your pets. They bring in warm cuddles and happiness. Some things you can do to prevent this parasite to get into your body is 1. Don't give your cat birds or mice to eat. 2. Be careful around their feces. And 3. Most importantly, cook your food properly so that there are no uncooked parasite eggs in them.
And that's all, folks.